Tonight we shall act undercover. But finally, we'll get the Montagues what they deserve.
About time.
Juliet! Nurse, he's gone, or maybe he never came. I've betrayed my only love. I've forsaken the holiest thing on this earth. Death would have been better. That's Tybalt. What is he up to? I must find him. I have to find him.
No, it's dangerous.
No.
Your father is already furious.
Let me go, nurse. Romeo! Romeo! Romeo!
Yes?
Talk to my daughter.
Do you mean Juliet?
Of course. Open the door, nurse.
No, no, I can't. She's very tired. And she said she would prefer to wait until tomorrow.
Well, it can't wait.
I say it can. You have already upset her enough for one evening. At least, let her have a peaceful night.
Doing here alone?
No, don't touch me!
Calm down. Do as I say.
Romeo!
Come.
Romeo.
Juliet. Are you hurt? What did that wretch do to you?
Nothing. All that matters is that you're here now. Don't leave me again.
I tried to get to you, Juliet, but I couldn't. I'm sorry. I will never leave you again. You're the only thing worth living for, my love. I want to make a promise to you tonight. You and I will be bound forever.
Are you asking me to marry you?
Yes. as the light of day will no longer destroy our dreams.
And our families will not be able to divide us. Yes, 1,000 times over.
This entry. You're safe now.
At what time shall I send you my nurse?
At midday. And if Friar Lawrence refuses again, then I will take you away until we find someone ready to marry us.
It feels like 20 years will pass before that time.
I know. But go now before they see us.
You're back. Where the hell were you last night? Answer me!
I'm sorry I wasn't here.
Is that all you can say?
Father, what happened?
It was then. The truce is over. Whatever the prince says.
No, no, it can't be over, Father. He will have to punish them for what they did.
What are you saying? Can't you see he's on their side? What are you going to open your eyes?
They are already open.
I think you are keeping them closed on purpose. And so does your brother. Just when you should be getting out weapons to make them pay! Get rid of everything!
Bring the guard over here. We can load up the rest of this mess.
Killed in cold blood. No one is going to be punished for this. Tell me what I have to do.
I beseech you, Romeo. Enough revenge.
But in return, you have to do something for me, and you know what I'm talking about. I won't stand by and let the only beautiful thing in my life be destroyed.
And don't you think that what you want to do will make things even more difficult?
Friar, if I have changed, others can change too. And if love can't bring peace to reign between us, I don't know what else we can place our hopes in.
I shall marry you tomorrow morning at dawn. We'll announce it on Christmas Day, during Mass, in front of the bishop and the prince. But Romeo, perhaps you're right. This may be the last chance we have left to put an end to this war.
Bad news.
Both. I've never seen a day so beautiful and so frightful at once. Sometimes the beauty's in the frightfulness and the frightfulness in the beauty.
I beseech you.
You have to ask for permission to go to confession.
Confession? Tomorrow, at dawn, at the Abbey, Romeo will be waiting for you there to make you his wife.
Father.
Juliet. Sorry for the things I said to you yesterday. It's just the mere idea of, well, I was furious.
Can I go to Friar Lawrence to confess and ask for his advice?
Very well.
There's no doubt they love each other. And if you had them meet, it must be part of your plan.
This? No. Nor this. And to think I dreamt of sewing a beautiful wedding dress for you.
But who cares about the dress? I'm so happy that I could get married in rags.
You're right. Tomorrow you'll marry the man you love.
Yes. So please, don't be so sad.
My child, I've known you since the day you were born. I nursed you, I watched over you night and day. I helped you through all the bad times, praying all the while.
I know. You've always been my real mother.
You are the only joy in my life. And I pray to God that he wouldn't take you from me too, that you might live, grow up. That one day you would have had a beautiful wedding. You would have had children, little ones that I would have raised.
Then all your prayers are about to be answered.
What are you talking about? You're marrying in secret, like a thief. If only I could come with you.
I know. And I'm sorry, too. But it's wiser if I go alone.
May God protect you, my child.
You sent for me.
Juliet has gone to confession to Friar Lawrence. Something bothers me.
She's ready.
Excellency, how difficult it is to write this message.
Friar Lawrence! Friar Lawrence!
Yes?
Is Juliet already here?
No, she isn't. You're so impatient. You think you're late when you're actually early. Come, come up. He's getting married and he's acting like a child.
The blessed youth.
I can't wait. But at the same time, I'm afraid it will never happen.
Father?
Finally, here she is.
Good morning, my spiritual father. I'm ready.
No. We'll do this quickly. And may heaven smile upon this celebration. This way, the both of you. Hey. Come.
Right, what shall I do?
Lock the door.
Yes.
Follow me.
Oh, Lord, bless and sanctify the love these newlyweds share. And may these rings be a symbol of faith, reminding them constantly of their love. And now let us invoke the Lord, trusting he will bestow his blessings and grace upon them. And with the powers bestowed to me, I pronounce you man and wife. In nomine Patris, Filii, Spiritus Sancti.
What are we going to do now?